टॉपिक ऑफ म्यूकस मेलानोमा स्क्वैमस सेल कार्सिनोमा एंड बेसल सेल कार्सिनोमा ओके सो वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. Now, nevus. So, beta, nevus is basically a benign neoplasm. It's a benign tumor of melanocytes. It is a benign exophytic, usually pigmented, congenital lesion of mucosa, or that is composed of a focal collection of a round melanocytes, which we call a nevus cell. Okay. The term nevus commonly used for mole. Nevi mostly occur on skin. Occasionally, it can occur on a mucous membrane. Okay, so anyway, if anyone asks about nevus, you must know that nevus is actually a benign tumor of melanocytes. Okay, so melanocytic nevus or pigmented nevus or mole appear as a tan to brown, uniformly pigmented. The nevus is usually small; it is less than 6 millimeter in size. Okay, the size is very important. The nevus is usually less than 6 millimeter. It appears as a macule or papules. Nevus may be more prominent during pregnancy. The lesions contain nevus cells, types of melanocytes. As you can appreciate it, that this is the gross appearance of a mole, the nevus. So, beta. Now the classification of nevus. Beta, anyone can ask the classification of nevus in your SEQ or in your Viva. The nevus is classified into the different types like intradermal nevus, junctional nevus, compound nevus, blue nevus, epitheloid or Spitz nevus. And there are certain more types like dysplastic nevus. Okay. So, beta, as you can appreciate it that this is an example of a junctional nevus in which these clusters or nest of a melanocytes are present in a junction. As you can appreciate it in picture A, this is basically an epidermis, while beta, this is a dermis. And at the junction of a dermo-epidermal junction, there is a collections of a melanocyte, which we call a nevus. This is example of a junctional nevus. Now, in picture B, as you can appreciate it, that these clusters of a melanocytes are present in epidermis as well as in the dermis. So, this is example of a compound nevus. And in picture C, you can appreciate it that these clusters are present only in a dermis. So, this is an example of a dermal nevus. Okay. I repeat again, beta, nevus is basically a collection of a melanocytes, benign melanocytes. Okay, they can be present in the dermis. If they are present only in the dermis, we call it intradermal nevus. When they are present at the junction of epidermo-dermo-epidermal junction, then we call it junctional nevus. Or if they are present at both in the epidermis as well as in the dermis, or in the junctional and in the dermis, then we called it the compound nevus. Okay, so now the intradermal nevus. The intradermal nevus occur in the oral cavity, mostly on the hard palate or gingiva. It mostly present as a pigmented lesion with brown to black in color, with slightly elevated papule or flat macule. But histopathologically, it is characterized by a nest, cords, or sheets of a nevus cells confined to the connective tissue. Clear? And the cells of a nevus may be epitheloid, lymphocytes-like, spindle, or multinucleated types. Mitotic figures are usually absent. Okay, as we know that the nevus is basically a benign tumor, so the mitotic activities are absent. It is actually the collection of the melanocytes. These melanocytes may look like epitheloid cells, lymphocytes like, or spindle cells. Okay, now the treatment of intradermal nevus includes, as a general rule, all solitary pigmented papules or nodules of the oral cavity should be excised. Once excised, the nevus do not tend to recur. So, beta, in this picture, you can appreciate it that this is the epidermis, okay? This is the dermis, and this is the junction. This is the junction, dermo-epidermal junction, okay? As you can appreciate it in this picture, beta, the clusters of these melanocytes are present in a dermis. So, this is an example of an intradermal nevus, okay? Okay, now about a junctional nevus. Histopathologically, the junctional nevus is characterized by the presence of a nevus cell nest in the basilar region of the epithelium. No nevus cells found in the surrounding connective tissue, meaning the nevus cells are present at the basal layer. These are present at the junction, at the dermo-epidermal junction, as you can appreciate it that. The nevus cells are present at the junction. And the compound nevus is histopathologically characterized by the combined nevus cells in the intradermal as well as the junctional areas. As you can appreciate it that these nevus cells are present in the dermis as well as at the junction. Okay? Clear? So, this is all about the nevus. Okay, beta? Beta, I repeat again, today we are discussing about the skin. In skin, you have to prepare the topic of nevus, melanoma, squamous cell carcinoma, and basal cell carcinoma of the skin. Okay, so now, till now, we are able to know about the nevus. Anyone can ask in your Viva, what is nevus? You must reply that the nevus is actually a collection of, is a benign tumor of a melanocyte, in which there is a collection of a melanocytes. Seen these the nevus is classified as intradermal, junctional, or compound type. When the nests are present in the dermis, only in the dermis, we called it intradermal nevus. While when the clusters of these melanocytes are present at the junction, we call it junctional nevus. And when there is a combination of a intradermal as well as junctional nevus, we call it compound. Okay. So now melanoma. It's a melanoma is basically a malignant neoplasm of melanocytes. Okay, these tumors originate in the pigment producing melanocytes in the basal layer of the epidermis. Okay, with the inner skin, there are two components, epidermis and dermis. In epidermis, in the basal layer, there is a presence of a melanocyte. Whenever there is a malignancy in the melanocytes, we call it melanoma. Okay, these cancerous growths develop when there is unrepaired DNA damage. The pathology, the pathogenesis of this is actually there is a defect in the DNA. There is a defect in the DNA synthesis, and there is an unrepaired DNA damage occurs on the melanocytes, which trigger the mutation that lead the skin cells to multiply rapidly and form a malignant tumor. Okay? Melanoma often resembles moles. Some develop from moles. The majority of the melanoma are black or brown, but they can also be skin colored, pink, red color, etc. But if melanoma is recognized and treated early, it is almost always curable. But if it is not, the cancer can advance and can spread to the other parts of the body, and it becomes hard to treat and can be fatal. Okay? So, melanoma is a malignant neoplasm of melanocytes. Okay? And this mainly occurs due to the unrepaired DNA damage of melanocytes. So, the melanoma is deadly if not caught at its earlier stages. It may be localized to aggressive tumor, metastasized, resistant to the treatment. Melanoma beta is mostly more than 10 millimeter in diameter at diagnosis. Okay? Keep it in your mind, if it is a small, less than 6 mm, then it is most likely a nevus. But melanoma is more than 10 mm in size, okay? There is changes in the color is seen in a melanoma. It is in color, size, or shape of a pigmented lesion. Black, brown, red, dark, blue, and green, okay? Zone of white or flesh color, hyperpigmentation may be seen. Borders of melanoma are irregular and often notched. Okay, beta. Now the risk factor. Beta, anyone can ask about the risk factors of melanoma. So everyone is at some risk for melanoma, but increased risk is mostly depends upon several factors like sun exposures, like number of moles on the skin, like family history, genetic mutation. So ultraviolet radiations are dangerous to the skin, and it can induce skin cancers like melanoma. People who live in a location that have a more sunlight develop more skin cancer. Okay, and atypical moles can be a precursor to melanoma. Okay, and putting the patient on at increased risk of melanoma. Clear? So now the alarming sign ABCD of melanoma. In melanoma, we see there is an asymmetry, there is irregular border, or there may be the variegated colors. So diameter greater than 6 millimeter, any change in appearance is alarming sign, the sign for melanoma. So beta, as you can appreciate it, that the lesion of a melanoma is characterized by asymmetry. There is asymmetry, there is irregular border, there is a variegation in the color, different colors, and there is evolution. Okay, I will show you this again. This is the picture of normal. As you can appreciate that if these are the a pigmented lesion with a regular border with symmetry of the lesion, while in melanoma there is asymmetry, as you can appreciate it, that the borders are irregular, there is multiple color in melanoma, and the lesion is larger in diameter, and there is changes in size, shape and color. The lesions are of different size and shape. Okay, so now the histomorphological types of melanoma. Because the melanoma may be the superficial spreading melanoma, and the melanoma is limited to the superficial dermis or in upper dermis, or it may be the nodular melanoma, it may be the lentigo maligna melanoma, actral lentiginous melanoma, and amelanatic melanoma. These are the different types of melanoma. Okay, in superficial spreading melanoma is the most common histological type, and it appears as a flat pigmented lesion. Okay. While the nodular melanoma is the second most common type, and there is a vertical growth pattern. Okay, and the worst prognosis is based on the higher average of tumor thickness. Okay, means till now you are able to know about the melanoma. What is melanoma? Melanoma is actually the malignant neoplasm of melanocytes. Okay, it is occurred due to the DNA damage. And the main causative factor is ultraviolet radiation. Okay, and there is a different certain types like superficial spreading melanoma, nodular melanoma, lentigo maligna melanoma. Okay, and nodular melanoma having a worse prognosis. So now the microscopical features. The features of melanoma in situ and dermal involvement of atypical melanocytes, the cytological atypia, and no maturation. Okay, and the classical features are junctional activity with obscure the dermal epidermal junction and pagetoid spread individually and in clusters through the epidermis. Beta means in melanoma there is atypical cells are seen in the dermis. Okay, for the dermis may be atypical cells, these atypical cells are cytological atypia, and these atypical cells or these tumor cells obscure the tumor obscure the dermoepidermal junction. Okay, prominent melanin pigmentation can be seen. Okay, large cells with abundant eosinophilic finely granular cytoplasm, nuclear pseudo inclusions, folds or grooves can be seen. Marked atypia with pleomorphic nuclei with large eosinophilic nucleoli. Okay, beta, as you can appreciate it, that these are the microscopic images of melanoma. As you can appreciate it, that these are the tumor cells with melanin pigmentation. This is the melanin pigmentation. This is the image of a tumor cells in the dermis. As you can appreciate it, that these all are the tumor cells. Okay, it shows pleomorphism. And in this image, you can appreciate it, that beta, dermoepidermal junction is obscured by the tumor cells. Okay. These all are the tumor cells. The prominent nucleoli, as you can appreciate it, that the nucleoli are prominent. Okay, so now we can classify the tumor into a different level, like level 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 on the basis of their invasion. If the tumor is involving only the epidermis, we call it level 1 or melanoma in situ. In level 2, the tumor is involving the involving the papillary dermis. Okay. In level 3, there is invasion, fill and expand the papillary dermis. Okay. While in level 4, they invade the reticular dermis. And level 5, it involves the subcutaneous tissue. Okay. These are the different levels, which we call the Clark's level. And the prognosis of tumor is dependent upon the level of invasion. Clear? So, now, Peter, till now, we are able to know about the nevus melanoma. Nevus is a benign lesion. It is actually a benign neoplasm of melanocytes, while melanoma is actually the malignant neoplasm. The size of the nevus is less than 6 mm mostly, while the size of melanoma is more than 10 mm. There are certain types of nevus like intradermal nevus, junctional nevus, compound nevus, while in the melanoma, it may be the superficial spreading melanoma, nodular melanoma, and lentigo malignant melanoma. Okay? Then we must know in a nevus cell that the melanocytes are benign. There is no cytological atypia. There is no mitosis. While in melanoma, there is cytological atypia. There is a mitosis, prominent nucleoli. There is obscure of the dermo-epidermal junction. Okay. So the behavior of nevus is benign, while the behavior of melanoma is malignant. It can be spread. Okay. Now we will discuss about the skin non-melanocytic tumor, pre-malignant and malignant epidermal tumor. So, first of all, we will discuss about the actinic keratosis. But the actinic keratosis is a benign lesion. It is actually the precursor lesion to the cancers. It occurs in a sun-damaged skin, sun-exposed area. It is associated with hyperkeratosis and it involves a lightly pigmented individual. Exposure to the ionizing radiations and toxins are the risk factors. And the lesion is usually less than 1 centimeter in diameter. It is tan, brown, red, or skin color. It may be said to be the cutaneous horn. Peter, as you can appreciate it, that this is the image of actinic keratosis. This is the lesion, which we call the cutaneous horn. Okay, cutaneous horn. So microscopically, beta actinic keratosis is associated with the basal cell and squamous layer atypia and disorderly maturation, hyperkeratosis and parakeratosis. Okay, there may be an atrophy of the epidermis surface. It means in skin, under we know that there are two components, epidermis and endermis. In epidermis, there is the atrophy of the epidermis, and in the basal layer, there is a atypical cell seen. Usually no granular layer except at follicular orifice. Elastosis and often chronic inflammation is seen at the dermis. Follicular apparatus and intraepidermal fluid ducts are spared. Okay. So, may have a coexisting melanocytic atypia. But as you can appreciate it that in this picture, okay, this is the epidermis, okay, and this is the dermis. Okay. In actinic keratosis, we see the atypical cell in the basal layer. As we know that it is a precursor lesion, so there is no invasion. These atypical cells are lying on the basal layer only. Okay, and there is a blue area. Dekh rahe hain on the upper dermis. This is the elastosis. Okay, elastosis is seen in the upper dermis. Elastosis, and there is a chronic inflammation in the dermis. So keep it in your mind, actinic keratosis, it is a precursor lesion in which the atypical cells are present at the basal layer of epidermis and there is an atrophy of the epidermis. As you can appreciate it that the epidermis is atrophic, okay? And the dermis shows elastosis. So now, squamous cell carcinoma, very important. But the squamous cell carcinoma is usually occur on a sun-exposed site. In sites in older pupils, increase in men than in women, less commonly metastasized. Squamous cell carcinoma in situ carcinoma is sharply defined, red scaling plaque. invasive lesion associated with nodular, hyperkeratotic scalp, and male scalp. It involves all the level of the epidermis. So, in squamous cell carcinoma, may appear as a form or rod nodule, may appear as a bit of flat sore with a scaly crust or a new sore or raised area on an old scar or ulcer. Okay, a rough scaly patch on your lip that may evolve to an open. These are the different sites. Okay, so beta, as you can appreciate it that these are the gross image of squamous cell carcinoma. You can appreciate it that in this picture, the margins of the squamous cell carcinoma is elevated. In this picture, it looks like a wart-like lesion. And in this picture, the margins are irregular. Clear? So, this is also an image of a squamous cell carcinoma. As you can appreciate it, that the tumor, this is a tumor with a raised irregular borders. So, this picture shows the different locations of a squamous cell carcinoma. It may occur on a lip, it may occur on a hands, on a cheeks, on a ears. Okay, on a all sun exposed area can be affected by squamous cell carcinoma. So, microscopically, the squamous cell carcinoma, it is actually carcinoma of keratinocytes that infiltrate the dermis. Okay, as we know that in actinic keratosis, the tumor cells are confined to the basal layer, while in squamous cell carcinoma, the keratinocytes infiltrate the dermis. Okay, and an associated precursor lesion, which we call the actinic keratosis. We may be associated with the squamous cell carcinoma. It may be seen along with squamous cell carcinoma. Spectrum of histological features all shear the downward growth below the level of adjacent dermis. So grading based on the degree of differentiation means and keratinization. It is divided into well-differentiated, moderately differentiated, and poorly differentiated. The well-differentiated tumors are easily recognizable squamous epithelium. Okay, means beta, in a well-differentiated tumor, there is a less pleomorphism, there is a less atypia, there is a more keratinization, more keratin pearls are seen, and there is intercellular bridges. Okay, while in a moderately differentiated tumor, there is a focal keratinization. And there is a features between the wall and the poorly differentiated. But in poorly differentiated tumor beta, there is a no or minimal keratinization, marked nuclear atypia. Okay. And in undifferentiated tumor, there is no keratinization and immunohistochemical stains are required for confirmation. Okay. To exclude the melanoma or sarcoma. Clear? So this picture is very, very important. As far as your OSP is concerned, it may be asked in your OSP whether this is the microscopic image of well-differentiated squamous cell carcinoma. As you can appreciate it, that this pink is a keratin pearls. Okay, these are the keratin pearls. This is an example of well-differentiated squamous cell carcinoma. And epithelium shows a marked keratinization and a minimal nuclear pleomorphism. While in this picture, you appreciated these are the mitoses. This is the example of pleomorphic cells. So this is an example of a moderately differentiated squamous cell carcinoma. Clear? So, beta, now a basal cell carcinoma. Beta, basal cell carcinoma is the most commonest invasive tumor of the skin. It's rarely metastasized. It is less aggressive tumor. Okay, it mostly involves, like a squamous cell carcinoma and the melanoma, it mainly involves the sun exposed sites and in lightly pigmented pupils. Immunosuppression, inherited defect in DNA repair may be the pathogenesis of basal cell carcinoma, which is associated with dilated subepidermal blood vessels, telangiectasis, rolled margin, erosion or ulceration may be seen. Rolled or raised border, telangiectasis over the surface of the tumor is mostly seen. Okay, so beta, as you can appreciate it, that this is the gross picture of basal cell carcinoma. This is a tumor with a raised margin or a rolled margin. Okay, so Microscopically, beta, the microscopic features of basal cell carcinoma is very characteristic. It shows up basaloid cells, means blue cells, with scant cytoplasm, with very small amount of cytoplasm, and elongated hyperchromatic nuclei with peripheral palisading, means the cells are lying parallel to each other at their ends. And there is a peritumoral clefting and mucinous alteration of surrounding stroma. Okay, because anyone can ask about the microscopic features of basal cell carcinoma. So you must keep it in your mind that basal cell carcinoma is associated with the presence of a basaloid cells, a cells with scanty cytoplasm, increased mitosis, hyperchromatic nuclei, peripheral palisading. The tumor cells are lying parallel to each other at their ends. Peritumoral clefting and mucinous alteration of the surrounding stroma. I will show the picture of the basal cell carcinoma. And in basal cell carcinoma, there is also a mitotic figure, apoptotic bodies, the presence of a myxoid stroma, and peripheral clefting has been suggested to be the most helpful to distinguish the basal cell carcinoma from the basaloid tumor. Okay? So, beta, as you can appreciate it, that this is the epidermis, this is the dermis. Okay? So, you can appreciate it that these are the nest of the tumor cells. Okay? And you can appreciate it that there is a peritumoral clefting. This cleft, this white space is a cleft between the tumor cells and the stroma. Okay, number one. Number two, as you can appreciate it, that the palisading of the tumor cells. These tumor cells are lying parallel to each other at the ends. And there is a myxoid stroma here, like this light blue, this myxoid stroma, surrounding stroma. Okay. So, here are different common subtypes of basal cell carcinoma. These include nodular type, superficial type, infiltrative type, basal squamous carcinoma. Within a nodular type, the basaloid tumor cells are present in a nodular configuration in a dermis. While in a superficial type, the basal cell carcinoma cells are present in the superficial dermis. While in infiltrative type, or the tumor cells are infiltrated throughout the dermis. While in basal squamous cells type, there is a basal cell carcinoma plus admits the foci indistinguishable from the squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, so beta, as you can appreciate in this picture, that these are the basal cells, and this is the example of a superficial spreading basal cell carcinoma. This is the epidermis, this is the dermis, and the tumor cells are present only on the superficial dermis. Okay. While this is an example of a nodular type, okay, the tumor the basal cell carcinoma range in a nodular configuration, we call it nodular type. While this is an example of an infiltrative type, in which these bands of a tumor cells are infiltrated into the stroma. Okay, so Peter, you can appreciate it that this is the difference between basal cell carcinoma and squamous cell carcinoma. Basal cell carcinoma is most common type of skin cancers. Okay, while the squamous cell carcinoma is more common cancers in an immunosuppressive patient or a transplant patient. Peter, please keep it in your mind whenever anyone asks about you that in a SCQ, in a scenario, the patient is present. Patient is presented with a history of a transplantation or immunosuppressive patient. So most common tumor in immunosuppressive patient or transplant patient is squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, the gross. The basal cell carcinoma is appear as a shiny, pearly, papule or nodule, while the squamous cell carcinoma is present as a hyperkeratotic lesion. Okay. And there is a telangiectasis is seen in the basal cell carcinoma. Basal cell carcinoma grows slowly, so there is less chances of metastasis. While squamous cell carcinoma can be more aggressive than the basal cell carcinoma. And with both the basal cell carcinoma and the squamous cell carcinoma, both usually occur on a sun-exposed areas. Okay, so till now we covered our topic of skin. In the skin, your exam, anyone can ask about the nevus, about the melanoma, about the squamous cell carcinoma, about the basal cell carcinoma. Okay, you must know about what is nevus, what is melanoma. Okay, what are the types of nevus? What are the types of melanoma? Okay, what are the features of nevus? Nevus is a collection of a nest of a melanocytes, while a melanoma, the tumors are infiltrated into the dermis. Okay, what are the histological features of melanoma, prominent nuclei, atypia, infiltrated nuclear dermis, melanin incontinence, mitotic figure, okay, these obscure of the dermoepidermal junction. Okay, beta. And then anyone can ask about the risk factors of melanoma, risk factors of squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, you must know about the grades of squamous cell carcinoma. They're well differentiated, small, poorly differentiated, and well differentiated, moderately differentiated, and poorly differentiated on the basis of their differentiation. And anyone can ask in your OSCE about the squamous cell carcinoma. You must know risk factors of both these tumors, as well as the microscopic features of basal cell carcinoma. The features of basal cell carcinoma are basaloid cells, small cells with scanty cytoplasm, hyperchromasia, palisading, to get you palisading of tumor cells, clefting, peritumoral clefting, zooid stroma. Okay, this is all about the skin. Okay, जी, okay बेटा, this is all about the skin. If anyone, इसको unmute कर दे. बेटा, if you have any query, you can ask. बेटा, if you have any query, you can ask. Please raise your hand. Okay, thank you, Veda.